Hi there, this is Gordon from Cobry. We are official Google Cloud partners and we specialise in helping organisations make the most of G Suite. So this is our latest episode of the Work From Home series, where we're going to be looking at some tips and tricks of the different apps throughout G Suite to help you work more efficiently while at home. Today I'm going to be focusing on Google Chat, which is going to tie in with some of the other tools like Google Meet, so you can stay in touch with your colleagues, collaborate, and be a lot more efficient while working at home during the lockdown. So let's dive in and we'll see what we can do. So I'm going to start here just on the new tab page for Google Chrome, which we always recommend that you use when you're using G Suite. I mean, that's the browser that was built for intended use for G Suite. All the apps are optimized to be used through Google Chrome, and it's incredibly secure. So we would always recommend using Chrome when using G Suite. And you might notice across the top here, I've got my kind of frequently used apps pinned across the top so that I've got easy access. They're always there, and they don't take a huge amount of space up across the top of my Chrome browser. So to get into Google Chat, we're going to have a look over here to the app launcher in the top right. Come down, select chat from the drop down, and let it load up. If you are interested in using some pin tabs to save that bit of screen space, all you need to do is right click on the tab, come down to pin, and it's going to squash it down so it's nice and neat there, and you can keep your commonly used ones up there for easy access. So Google Chat is an internal messaging service for within G Suite. It's all included, and it's instant messaging with your own colleagues. So it's internal at the moment, and it lets you get quick answers to questions you might have, whether that's direct to one person, like an example here, my colleague Rowan, or whether it's to a team of people where you might want to make use of the room features that you have in chat. Basically for this, we can create specific rooms for different use cases. You might want to do that on a department by department basis. So you would have one for HR, one for sales, maybe one for finance. Or the alternative could be you would do it per office. So if you've got a few offices scattered around the country, you could go for one for Glasgow, the remote team, maybe there's a team in London as well, or Blackpool. And you can set these up so that everybody that's in there will get updated with any conversation or any kind of new updates that they need to follow along with the projects. They can easily keep track there. So let's have a quick look at some of the other features here. If we look down just below the rooms, you can see here that there's an option here for bots. Bots are a really nice little kind of add-on for chat, which you can use to kind of automate things and use a little bit of artificial intelligence to try and make things a little bit slicker. The first one that we would recommend that you'd always use here is Google Drive. Basically, this is going to pull all of the notifications that you get from Google Drive. Rather than having them in individual emails in your inbox, we're going to have it come into one single thread within Google Chat. So that's a really nice handy feature there, and I'll maybe let you guys explore the bots that are available. You can do so just by clicking on the plus there, having a scroll through some kind of popular ones, or you can do a search for something a bit more specific. Okay, so we'll come back from the bots section just now, and we'll take another look at the instant messaging, the live chat with colleagues. So the first part I'm going to do is just show you how easy it is to start chatting. So this is my colleague Rowan. I'm just going to say, "Hi Rowan, how are you?" And we'll see if he's online at the moment. All that I'm going to do here is click on the little Drive icon, and we're going to pull up a project proposal that we've been working on that I want to get a little bit of his help with. So all we need to do is click there. You can see now that the link appears. I'm going to send a link, and he'll be able to click that open and kind of review it whenever he has time. Might not be right away, but if so, that'd be great. What we can do next is we can actually just send him a meeting link, which he can click and just jump straight in. So why don't we have a chat through it? And all I need to do now is click the little icon here for the meet, and that's going to pull up a link, and all I need to do now is hit enter, and it's going to pop up here. So Rowan is just going to click this same link that he sees on the other side. I can just click join now. Oh, there he is. Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm very well, thanks. How are you?
Good. Yep, not bad at all. Just doing a little overview of how to use Google Meet through Google Chat and how all the apps come together. So thank you for sparing a couple of minutes of your day. You're going to be doing a little bit of a recording for us for Google Meet in a bit more detail, right?
Sure am. I'm going to go through all of the tools of one of what I think is the best G Suite apps out there. So yeah, very much looking forward to telling the people about that.
Excellent. Okay, well, look forward to seeing it, and thanks for joining today. Catch you later on.
Alrighty, see ya.
Cheers, mate. Bye. So there we go, that's the chat finished. We can either click this to return to home screen, but if we want to just close it off, we can just quit the app there. The one difference between chatting within rooms and chatting direct with somebody in a direct message is that you can use threads within rooms, which means you can have multiple topics going on in the same room without things getting confused and getting kind of lost in between. So all I'm going to do here is click new thread and say, this is a conversation about fruit. And then if we wanted to carry on that conversation about fruit, then we could do in here bananas, but if we wanted to then have a conversation about veg, maybe, which is a conversation, then you know we could start talking about broccoli in here, if we wanted to, if that was what was kind of top of your list of priorities, then you could. And then always the most recently used thread is going to come to the bottom. So it's nice and easy to stay up and up to date with everything. And if you wanted to tag people in these chats, you can do at all, and it's going to tag everybody in the room. Or you can tag individual people, such as my colleague Rowan. And if I hit enter there, then he's going to get a little notification that he needs to come through and make sure he reads it and actions anything that's being asked. So that is a quick overview of Google Chat and a little taster on Google Meet. So I hope that's been helpful for you. And if you'd like to find out anything more, then get in touch with us or just stay tuned for the next episodes, and hopefully you can pick up a few other tricks. Thanks a lot. See you later.